Welcome back. We got another unboxing video for you guys. Ramping up into April. I don't know where the months are going, but we're here.
We made it.
We're
surviving.
A lot of big names in here. Yeah, we're surviving and stuff.
And striving.
Surviving and striving. Striving to survive. Okay. Yeah. Well, I got some good big names for you. I know I got a lot of people that are going to be excited about a good handful out of here. So let's go ahead and get started. One of those names, we got into a Heather Graham.
Danger in numbers.
Okay. Starting off real strong, we got a new Janet Ivanovich. This one is a Fox and O'Hare novel. Probably got them two on the front.
That's probably them.
We don't get to see their full faces, so you can imagine. Imagine what they look like.
When you see his face a little bit, but her face is cut off. Her head is cut off. Those pictures you used to take when you were a kid.
Oh, yeah. They're like,
and like you couldn't top see of gas.
Like crap. Okay. Next we have another big one. James Patterson, The Palm Beach Murders. Killer suspense from the author of The House Next Door. The author of thousands of other books.
Yes. The author.
He's got ghost authors.
Yeah.
Okay. Next we have, this one looks adorable. It's called The Seed Keeper. I don't know if it's actually adorable, but the colors. The cover's pretty. That's what I'm saying. I have no idea of the contents of the inside.
We don't know, but we're judging the book by its cover here.
We're judging the book by its cover, and it's
really cute.
It's cute.
Could be incredibly disturbing.
Could be. Next, we have The Confessions of Franny Langston. It's Langton.
Good job.
Yeah.
It's hard to read. The font's real pretty.
We're old enough to have learned cursive, but I'm not going to pretend I can read it all the time.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's too fancy.
Langton.
Oh, wouldn't you think it was Langston?
Yeah. I wanted to put an S in there too, so.
Next we have Lisa Scottoline with her new book, Eternal, a novel. Something's happening eternally. There's a plane.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
I have no idea what is eternal, but something's eternal. Alright. Next we have a new book. An older book, but a new book for us from Michael Poore, who's the author of Reincarnation Blues. Up jumps the devil.
Woof!
He's making s'mores on the road. Check him out.
Yeah! Mellows.
Make it s'mores.
Make those mellows.
Next, we have A World on the Wing, The Global Odyssey of Migratory Birds.
So if you're a bird, sounds good.
This would be a good one.
Bird book.
So you say, hey, I know these guys come up this time of year, these guys come up this time of year. You maybe have some intuition as to why.
Yeah.
Why they migrate.
Now
who migrates to where.
When we read this book, we will know.
We will know. Next, we have a cute kid's book. It's called The Tree in Me.
Oh.
Absolutely adorable art.
Yeah.
It's nice. Yeah, it's nice springy colors. We need that right now.
Yes, we do. Where are our spring colors?
Right now we just get the today. We need it.
April showers.
We're already getting those. Next we have A Question Mark is Half a Heart. Technically it is. That's right.
Yep.
Think about it.
It's true.
Think about it. So two questions make a heart. I suppose. And a dot. Also. Two dots.
Yeah.
Next, we have this absolutely gorgeous little book from Joan M. Harris, Orphea. And it's got a sheen on it, you can see.
Oh, shiny. There you go. Ooh.
Yeah.
Shiny.
Beautiful. Okay. Oh, we're gonna have some excited little kids. New Dogman. It's New Dogman. sign for a new dog man. What's his name? Wuthering Heights Dog Man. Thanks, Dave Cokie.
Oh, look, they're holding hands. Oh, sweet.
I think Dog Man is so cute.
Wuthering Heights.
Wuthering Heights.
Next.
Oh, next we have a cat. This one is Scaredy Cat.
Scaredy Cat.
James Patterson. We have two Pattersons in this box.
Yay!
This one's for kids, though.
This is for the kids.
Mm-hmm. Or if you want to read it in your adult.
You can read it.
But I wouldn't let a kid read the other one.
Yeah, don't let kids read the other one.
It goes one way, not the other, really.
Yep.
Next, we have Raleigh Jefferson's Awesome Friendly Spooky Stories by Jeff Kinney!
Ah!
It's got some Zambos at the bottom. Some zombies.
No,
yeah,
no.
Some zombies.
No. Uh-huh. I'm trying to cover them up with my fingers.
They'll bite you if you do that. Next, we have a book about roller derby. It's called Bruised by Tanya Potato.
Bruised. They look cool.
Very stylish.
Yeah. Cool book.
Next, we have Plunder, a memoir of family property and Nazi treasures.
Ooh.
And I think it's about repatriation of stolen things.
Mm.
That's something we don't talk about a lot in war.
Mm-hmm.
When things have to go back and finding out where they go back to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
Next, we have another big name. Dean Koontz.
The other Emily.
No.
No Emily's here. This is the
no
other Emily.
No Emily's in this room.
This is the other Emily.
She's the other Emily.
You're the other Emily, I think. Wouldn't, if there are two Emilys in the room, one of them would always be the other Emily.
You're
the other Emily.
You're the other Emily.
I'm the other Emily. Yeah.
We're all
the other Emily.
We're all the other Emily. Sorry if your name's really Emily.
You can be Emily Primo. Emily number one.
Emily number one.
Next, we have A New Model by Ashley Graham. What confidence, beauty, and power really look like.
Mm-hmm. They look like this.
Mm-hmm.
Bam.
Next, we have Red Island House by Andrea Lee.
Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty cover.
I do like that cover
a
lot.
Gorgeous art.
I like it.
Another big name. This is the big one, I think, out of all of them. We got another Stuart Woods. This one's called Double Jeopardy. It's the next adventure in the line of Stone Barrington.
Oh, no, Stone Barrington.
That's it. That's Stuart.
Sorry. Ooh, Ian's really thundering out there.
Next, we have The One Thing You'd Save by Linda Sue Park.
The One Thing.
I think it's about if something were to happen, what would be the one thing you would take?
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
My child.
My doggy.
Both. Same answer.
Yeah. Next, we have Transient Desires by Donna Leon. A Commissario Guido Brunetti mystery.
Oh.
That sounds Italian. That sounds very Italian. Because his name is Guido.
Yeah.
It's very Italian.
We like it. It's our book.
It's our book.
We earned it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really this person.
Don't make any claims you can't back up. She's not Donna Leone. Donna Leone.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all I've got for you this time.
Yay.
We'll be back in April with more things to show off. If you didn't pick up anything last time from our last box, we did get those DVDs out. Those are all available to be checked out now.
Mm-hmm.
Check our new book displays. We have one for nonfiction. If you walk in the doors, turn to the left. It's on top.
Mm-hmm.
All of our fiction is going to be back up against that door that you came in, and then the big wooden tables in the middle. And the new movies are on the little shelves before you get to the rest of the DVD cases.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to help finding like new junior fiction or young adult, you can just ask us.
Yep.
Normally it's just on the shelves on the side. That's how you can tell this is the new stuff and where to find it. Or
we try to keep it pretty simple around here.
We do. We try to keep it easy.
We're good guys.
If you want to reserve online, you can do that. You just log into your account on the catalog. Or you
and
can call
we
up.
Can still do curbside.
Yes, we can
anyone
still do curbside.
Who wants to do that.
So if you don't feel like coming in, I mean, even if you just don't want to get out, really, you just don't want to get out of your car, you want to wear your pajamas or something, go ahead, call us up, get us to pick it out, we'll bring it out to you.
Yep.
All right.
We're cool like that.
We are cool like that. Okay, we'll see you next time.